的朋友 Hope Nation 了 Hope 的家人，不管你现在在哪里观看，我真的非常非常开心。如果你现在有想到一个你朋友的名字的话，赶快把这个连结分享出去。
Welcome everyone, and everyone who's watching online on Hope Nation. If right now you're watching this and you're thinking of a friend, just quickly send that link over to them right now so they can watch with us.
我相信今天的讲道会非常非常帮助他的生命。
I believe that this sermon is going to help your friend's life.
我们在上个礼拜有一个朋友，他说他那时候想到一个朋友，但他很不想分享出去。
Last week we had a friend who said they were thinking about someone they wanted to share this link to, but they didn't really want to send that link to them.
可是最后他顺服那个感动分享出去以后，
but after they did send that link to them,
他的朋友后来就持续的观看直播。
That friend continually watched the live stream.
持续在我们当中成为我们的 Hope Nation.
And then they also joined us and became Hope Nation.
我们真的非常开心你们可以加入我们的直播。
So we're so glad you can join us live stream.
不管你是谁，你们都属于这里。
No matter who you are, you all belong to this place.
希望我们可以很快就可以见到你们的本人。
And we hope that we can actually meet with you in person soon.
我们今天有一段经文是来自约翰福音的第四章。
So we have a passage from the Gospel of John.
我念给大家听。他回加利利的路上必须经过撒玛利亚，他是耶稣。于是他来到撒玛利亚的一座城，名叫叙加，靠近雅各留给他儿子约瑟的那一块地。雅各井就在那个地方。耶稣走路疲乏，坐在井旁休息。那时是中午时分，门徒都进城买食物去了。有一个撒玛利亚的妇人来打水，耶稣说，请你给我一点水吧。
John 4:4-8. Now he had to go through Samaria, so he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of ground Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well. It was about noon. His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" Let's pray together.
父，我们感谢你的同在。
Father, thank you for your presence.
我求你的灵来持续的运行在我们心里面。
May your spirit come and work in our hearts.
你在每一个人的心里面来工作。
Work in each and every person's heart.
让每一个听到的人都能够来被你来触摸。
So every person who hears would be touched by you.
让我们都能够被你来得着。
So that we would be more filled with you.
我们以下时间要完全交托在你手中。
We give you this time.
我们祷告奉主耶稣宝贵的名求。
We pray in Jesus' precious name.
Amen. 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 Wow, 请坐，请坐。
Please have a seat.
你知道，在这一阵子我特别的忙碌。
I've been really busy lately.
因为呢，在下一个月，我和我的未婚夫 Ray 即将要举办一场婚礼。
Because my fiance Ray and I are planning our wedding for next month.
对，所以我们在不管是可能是放假的时候，或者是我们下班的时候，都在弄婚礼的东西。
So no matter whether it's our vacation time or when we get off work, we're always busy with wedding planning.
Okay, 不是每个人都对我的未婚夫 Ray 非常的熟悉。
Perhaps not everyone is very familiar with my fiance Ray.
他很特别，他有个特异功能。
He's very special. He has this unique ability.
你知道他的特异功能就是呢，他可以在空气里面就可以察觉到我的情绪。
So his special power is that he can read my feelings through the atmosphere.
所以他对我的情绪很敏锐，只要我的情绪一转换的时候，他会马上发现。
So he's very sensitive to my emotions. If my emotions change, he can recognize it.
可能上一秒我们还说说笑笑的，还没事。
Perhaps we were just joking a minute ago.
然后我们就安静的走路。
And then we're walking silently.
突然我的一个感觉一转变。
And suddenly I thought of something and my emotions changed.
他会突然低头看着我说，怎么了？
He'll turn toward me and he'll be like, "What's up?"
所以我什么都骗不了他。
So I can't lie to him.
你会觉得这样很棒，对不对？
You probably think that's great.
你知道有一次我们小组出去玩一个 board game.
One time, our small group went out. We were playing a board game.
Okay, 那个 board game 叫做谁是间谍。
It's called Who's the Spy.
Okay, 所以每个人呢会抽到不同的角色。
So everybody picks a card and they have different roles.
你可能会抽到平民，你可能抽到间谍。
Maybe you'll get a citizen card or maybe you'll get the spy card.
所以平民跟间谍，你都有自己的指示要去做事情。
So according to the card, you have to act accordingly.
最倒霉有一个角色叫做白板。
But the worst role is actually the blank.
白板什么都不知道。
So the blank doesn't know anything.
可是他要假装自己知道一些东西。
But they need to pretend that they know who they are.
好死不死，那天我就抽到这个角色。
So that day, I actually got that card.
然后我们抽完角色，什么都还没开始哦。
So after we picked the card and the game hadn't even started,
他就好奇地问我说：“你是白板吗？”
He just turned to me and asked, "Are you the blank?"
你知道这时候就要 play cool。
You know, you have to play it cool at that time.
然后我就非常的诚恳看着他。
And I looked at him and said very seriously,
我不是白板。
No, I'm not the blank.
他就非常确定地指着我的脸。
And then he pointed to me and he was very certain.
大喊，你就是白板。
And then he yelled out, you are the blank.
我到现在还没有办法原谅他。
To this moment, I can't even forgive him for that.
因为那时候他的求生欲还没有发展出来 okay?
Because...
没有关系，不用翻，不重要。OK， 好。所以大家可能都会很羡慕。
So maybe you're very envious.
因为我们期待在我们这一生当中可以遇到一个这么懂你、这么了解你的人。
Because in our lives, we really hope somebody will understand you well.
你会觉得他好像是你的 soulmate.
You'll feel like, oh, this is my soulmate.
因为我们都有一个被爱、被了解的这个需求。
Because we all have a need to be loved and understood.
所以我们就期待一个可以完完全全的了解我们，然后这样子爱我们。
So we hope that there's someone who can fully understand us and love us completely.
所以我们就开始把我们的心事，把我们里面的东西来跟别人讲。
So we start to share what's in our hearts.
我们想要有人理解，我们想要有人可以来帮忙分担。
And we hope somebody will understand and help bear the burden.
可是即便你找到一个像瑞一样有特异功能的这个对象，
But even if you find someone that has supernatural abilities like Ray,
他也没有办法完完全全的了解你。
They will never be able to fully understand you.
因为我们可能会遇到有一个人，他愿意来跟你培养默契啊，很快就可以彼此理解啊。
Because you might find someone who you have great chemistry with.
你就觉得哇，你根本就是我肚子里面的蛔虫。
Your friend will be like, wow, you live inside of me.
可是对方 live inside， 我觉得这个怪怪的，但就是很懂我啦。
Well, oh, you're my parasite. That's better.
Yeah, very well. Okay, 好，谢谢。可是对方也还只是在那个更了解我们的过程当中。
But actually, that person's still on the journey of getting to know you better.
以至于有时候我们把我们的感觉说出来的时候
，So when you share your feelings with them，
对方因为不能了解，所以没有办法完全的来同理你。
And because they can't fully understand, so they can't fully empathize with you.
或者他依照你期待的东西来回应。
Or they can't respond in the way that you want or expect.
所以不管我们在这世界上面怎么样的去寻求
，So no matter how much you search，
我们都还是会有一个感觉，就是没有人真正了解我。
You'll still have this feeling in your gut that says no one can really understand me.
没有人真正了解我。
No one fully understands me.
因为就连我们都没有办法完全了解自己。
Because actually we're unable to fully understand ourselves.
It's true， 没有人会完全了解你。
Yes, no one will really fully understand you.
我很抱歉把你们从童话故事或者是琼瑶小说里面拉出来。
Sorry for bursting your fantasy.
可是一件事情发生的时候，我们每个人的成长背景、文化、心境这些都不一样。
So we all come from different cultures and backgrounds.
所以就算同一件事情发生在不同的人身上，不可能会有一样的感觉啊。
So even if the same incident occurs to two different people, they will have two different experiences.
所以我们在那个有一个声音，就是没有人完全了解我的那个声音里面，我们就会开始陷入一个终极的孤单。
So when that voice gets loud, that voice of no one truly understands me, then we kind of start to fall into that feeling of deep loneliness.
这就是为什么今天的讲到主题是面对孤单，还有救吗？
That's why today's sermon title is Relief for the Lonely Heart.
面对孤单还有救吗？
Relief for the Lonely Heart.
我们都曾经有过孤单的感觉。
We've all felt lonely before.
有时候我们说不上那个感觉到底是什么。
Sometimes we're not able to put our finger on that feeling.
可是当我们自己一个人的时候，有时候那个感觉冒出来的时候，会问自己说，是不是只有我一个人有这样的感受？
But sometimes when we're alone, we'll think, Is it just me that has this sense of loneliness?
可是我今天要告诉你，就是因为你很正常，所以你才会有这样的感觉。
But I want to let you know that it's because you're normal that you have this feeling.
你知道神创造整个世界，山川美景、动物、植物，一切都是美好的。
You know, God created the heavens and the earth, and everything was good.
可是只有一件事不好。
But there was only one thing that wasn't good.
神第一个指出的问题就是那人独居不好。
The first problem that God addressed was it's not good for man to be alone.
这就是为什么上帝他的解决方法就是让亚当有一个家庭。
And that's why God's solution to the problem was for Adam to have a family.
上帝来创造夏娃成为亚当的妻子。
And he created Eve to become Adam's wife.
所以孤单不是神对我们造下来人生的这个目的跟计划。
So God's purpose for us when He created us was not for us to be lonely.
我们每一个人受造的时候都有一个很自然的渴望，就是我们渴望一个亲密的关系。
So when we are created, we all have this innate desire to have an intimate relationship.
我们本来就会渴望有亲密的关系啊，我们想要有人也可以陪伴我，可以了解我。
We all desire intimacy. We want someone to be there for us, to walk with us.
我们可以常常分享生命中的点点滴滴，这些都是非常正常的需求。
We long for someone to share the highs and lows of life, and those are normal.
所以当耶稣和这位撒玛利亚妇人要水的时候，是正中午的时间。
And so when Jesus was asking the Samaritan woman for a drink of water, it was right around noon.
撒玛利亚妇人说：“你是个犹太人，怎么向我这撒玛利亚妇人要水喝？”原来犹太人和撒玛利亚人互不往来。耶稣回答说：“要是你知道上帝的恩赐，又知道向你要水喝的是谁，你早就求他了，他也早就把活水给你了。”妇人说：“先生，你没有打水的器具，井又深，你从哪里得到活水呢？我们的祖先雅各把这口井留给我们，他自己和他的儿女牲畜都喝这井里的水，难道你比他更伟大吗？”耶稣说：“人喝了这井里的水还会再渴，但是喝了我所赐的活水永远不会再渴。我所赐的水要在它里面成为生命的泉源，永流不息，直到永生。”妇人说：“先生，请你把这种水赐给我，我就不会再渴了，我也用不着来打水了。”耶稣说：“去叫你的丈夫来。”妇人说：“我没有丈夫。”耶稣说：“你说的对，你没有丈夫，因为你已经有过五个丈夫了，现在和你同居的也不是你的丈夫，你说的是实话。”
The Samaritan woman said to him, "You are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink? For Jews do not associate with Samaritans." Jesus said to her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." "Sir," the woman said, "you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and his livestock?" Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water." He told her, "Go, call your husband and come back." "I have no husband," she replied. Jesus said to her, "You are right when you say you have no husband. The fact is you have had five husbands, and the man you now have is not your husband. What you have said is quite true."
你知道这位撒玛利亚妇人 ，OK， 她名字太长了，我们就叫她小撒就好。
And so the Samaritan woman, because that's pretty long, we'll just call her Sammy.
小撒她曾经有五个丈夫。
You know, Sammy had five husbands.
现在的这个住在一起的也不是她的丈夫。
And now the guy she's living with is not her husband.
所以很有可能她是陷在一个不伦恋里面，是一个不正当的关系，所以她不想要遇到任何的人。
And so perhaps she's living within this immoral relationship, and that's why she doesn't want to meet anyone.
因为她在正中午的时候去打水，可是你要知道打水是一个非常累、非常辛苦的事情。
Because she went to draw water at noon, but you need to understand that drawing water is a very arduous task.
你知道，因为正中午非常的热，我们不会想要在正中午去慢跑、去运动，所以我们通常要打水、要运动，我们都会想要在凌晨或者是傍晚的时候。
And because it's the hottest at noontime, you wouldn't choose to exercise or draw water during that time. You choose to go early in the morning or late in the afternoon.
可是小撒他偏偏选在正中午的时候打水，为了要避开人群。
But Sammy chose to go at noon so that she can avoid anybody when she goes to draw water.
甚至我怀疑他可能当下有戴墨镜、口罩还有安全帽，因为他不想要任何人看到他。
You know, I bet she was wearing a helmet and a mask and sunglasses because she didn't want anyone to see her.
可是对小撒来说，他心里也会觉得，我也不想过这样的生活啊。
But inside her heart, Sammy's thinking, I don't want to live this kind of lifestyle.
他心里在想说，我就是想要定下来，所以我才结婚啊。
You know, I just want to get settled, and that's why I chose to get married.
可是你知道，在那个时候被休妻离婚是一个非常丢脸的事情。常常人家会觉得，是不是女生有什么问题，所以男人不要她。
But you know, at the time, if you got divorced, everybody will put a lot of shame on the woman and think there must be something wrong with her.
所以小撒也觉得很被拒绝啊，他就开始期待下一个男人可以更好的爱她，来接纳她。
And so Sammy felt very rejected, and she was hoping that the next man would love her better.
可是当小撒一次又一次把盼望放在下一段关系又结束又下一段关系又结束一次又一次的这个关系当中他感觉到自己很失败
But as she put her hope in the next relationship and it came, went around and around in the cycle and she kept on feeling more and more of a failure
所以现在这个孤单的小撒心里就想说谁想要当小三啊
So this, this lonely Sammy was thinking, who wants to be a mistress?
哪一个女人不想要这个男人完全的爱呢？
Which woman doesn't, what woman doesn't want a man's total love?
可是当我最孤单的时候，真的是他最了解我，他最关心我，他最在乎我。
And when I'm down, that's the person who will really love me and care for me.
而且他太太根本没有珍惜他，这样我们在一起不是更幸福吗？
And this guy, his wife doesn't even like honor him, you know? He's the one that cares for me. Aren't we just happy together?
所以小撒因为他心里面的这个孤单，他就不断的想要去寻找一个看起来可以为他付出真爱的人，然后就想要跟这个人在一起。
And so because of that loneliness in Sammy's heart, she kept on looking for a relationship that seemed to be able to provide her with love and she wanted to be with them.
紧密的在一起，没关系，还没结婚也没关系，我们就住在一起，这样我们就可以很紧密，常常在一起。
So we can be close together. It doesn't matter if we're not married yet. At least we can be close.
所以在这样子纠缠复杂的关系里面
，So in this complicated relationship,
小撒也很伤脑筋，因为当他上班的时候，他有个同事是笑脸迎人，对每个人都很 nice。
But it was such a headache for her because when she went to work, she had this colleague who was very nice and smiled at everyone.
可是当小撒进来的时候，这个女生脸马上垮下来，然后不跟她讲话。
But whenever Sammy stepped into the room, that girl's face just totally fell, and she refused to speak to her.
她就会想说，这女生是不是知道我的事情啊
？So Sammy thought maybe that girl knows what's going on in my life.
还是就是我这么讨人厌啊
？Or maybe I'm just really despicable.
然后楼下的管理员开始跟他讲话，也大小声。
And then even the guard downstairs started to talk really rudely to her.
会不会是因为他看到我常常带不同的男生回家
？Oh, is it because that he sees that I bring home different men to my house?
然后那天在等垃圾车的时候，邻居都闪得远远的，不想站在我旁边。
That last night when I went to throw out the trash, all my neighbors just avoided me.
所以小撒就开始远离群众，跟这个唯一懂她的男人一起过日子。
And so Sammy started to leave her social group, her social circle, and started just hanging out with this guy.
问题是这一位同居男友，他已经是他目前的 soulmate 了。可是，在遇到一些问题的时候，不管怎么沟通，对方还是没有完全理解。
But the problem is this guy that she's living with, who's kind of like her soulmate now, even when she talks about certain things, he wasn't able to fully understand her.
所以小撒开始进入到这个终极孤单的感觉。
And so Sammy fell into this deep sense of loneliness.
Okay, 当我们面对孤单之前，让我们先来问什么是孤单。
So before we face this question of loneliness, let's just look at what is loneliness.
Okay, 孤单是什么
？What is loneliness?
孤单是什么？孤单它不是独处，很多人以为孤单跟独处是同一件事情。
You know, loneliness and being alone are two separate things.
Okay, 独处非常的重要。
It's really important to be able to be alone sometimes.
我们都需要独处。
We all need that time.
因为我们都需要一段时间可以安静下来，然后疏解日常的压力，来缓和一整天的刺激。
Because we all need that downtime to be alone and to release all the stress and pressure we experience during the day.
独处可以让我们来整理思绪，我们带来更多的创意，还有让我们在独处里面可以重新得到力量。
And having that quiet time alone will actually produce even more creativity and give us more.
所以当我们自己和自己好好的相处，我们来重新检视自己的时候，我们可以在这里面来得到充电。
And so as we enjoy just being with ourselves, we can actually feel recharged in the process.
可是孤单是什么？
But what is loneliness?
孤单是一种心理的状态。
Loneliness is the state of your heart.
有时候是感觉我们被拒绝，或是我们被遗忘之后产生的一个感觉。
Sometimes it's the feeling you get after you've been rejected.
这样的孤单会让我们有一种被隔离的感觉，让我们常常觉得好像我是不被想要的，格格不入，或是不被接纳，走不进别人的世界。
And this feeling of loneliness will make you feel isolated, and you feel like there's a wall between you and other people. You just can't interact and be with them.
这样的孤单可能会造成你生理上面，还有你人际关系上面的一些伤害。
And actually, this kind of loneliness will hurt you physically and also in your relationships.
比如说，有时候我看到一些很美好的景色，我自然就会想要找人分享。
For example, sometimes I see some beautiful landscape or nature, and I want to share that with someone.
或是好不容易我们来完成一个挑战之后，我们想要来跟别人分享我们的喜悦。
And so, or sometimes you've overcome this big challenge, and you want to share your joy with somebody.
可是问题是，当我们身边没有一个人可以分享的时候，我们就会感觉到很孤单。
But the problem is, when there's no one like that to share those things with, you'll feel very lonely.
以至于现在有很多经济其实和孤单有关。比如说终点女友。
And so now there are a lot of things that, like a lot of, for example, there's escort companions.
对，所以你知道，因为我们要性交易其实是很简单的，你只要付个钱就可以和人有人与人的连接，对不对？
For example, you know, it's very easy to just have sex. You can just pay somebody and then you can have this connection with someone.
可是终点女友她不是为了要性哦，她是需要对方的陪伴。
But an escort companion, it's not because they want only sex. They actually want that companionship.
他可能只是需要对方和他做一点什么事情，然后我们一起来聊天分享，他就会感觉到一个温暖。
And maybe because they're just there with them, and they do things together, they feel this warmth.
或者有一些孤单的人，他开始会想要找食物来慰藉，他觉得身体很空，吃些食物感觉比较温暖。
Or another example is some people try to fill that loneliness with food. They eat something and they feel like a little bit of warmth from that.
有些人会是用消费的方式来安慰自己的感觉。我只要买了这个新衣服，我会觉得比较有慰藉，我会觉得比较温暖。
Some people use spending money as a way to fill that void, to feel warmth.
因为你在消费的时候，你拿出信用卡，你刷了会有一种快感，你就会感觉来自己很开心，转移对这个孤单的注意力。
Because when you buy things and you swipe your credit card, there's that rush of adrenaline, and then it kind of distracts you from that feeling of loneliness.
可是到头来，我们可以赚取很多的金钱，我们可以付出很多的代价，来换得我们想要的东西。
And so we can use a lot of money to, through different methods to obtain what we want.
可是当你心里面那个孤单感冒出来的时候，我们还是没有办法得到满足。
But when that sense of loneliness rises up again, you still will not be able to feel satisfied.
你知道爱抱怨的人有时候聚在一起，他们还可以有一个同温层，有一个短暂的安慰。
So you know people who like to complain, sometimes they'll gather together and complain together because they feel kind of warmth, the warmth of that.
可是孤单的人不一样。
But people who are lonely are different.
他会有一个感觉，就是就我这一个人啊，我走了，也没有人在乎。
They'll feel like, well, I'm still alone. So even if I wasn't here, no one will care.
所以很多人就会说，哎，我没有这样的状况啊。可是你却会习惯的去讨好别人，因为你需要被别人喜欢。你做到别人所要求的，你就会觉得融入在别人里面。
And a lot of people may think, well, I don't have this problem, but perhaps you try really hard to please other people, and you want to meet their expectations so that you feel accepted by them.
所以我们就开始逃避自己的感觉，我们把别人的需求当成是自己的需求。
And we run away from our feelings, and we start to take on other people's needs as our own.
我所有的情绪啊，想要啊，期待，我的梦想，都是别人的。
And so all my hopes, all my feelings, they all belong to someone else.
什么是做自己啊？我不懂哎。
What does it mean to be yourself? I don't know what that is.
我连自己的感觉是什么我都不知道。
I don't even know how I feel.
以至于有时候我们会以为自己追求的是成就啊，或者是我在追求别人的尊敬啊，我们被别人注意。
So sometimes we'll think, oh, I'm pursuing success, or I'm pursuing other people's attention or acclamation.
可是其实我们是需要透过这些来和别人连接。当别人注意我们的时候，我们就会感觉自己不孤单。
But what we're actually seeking after is that sense of connection through those feelings of success.
所以我们可能很不自觉地把别人当作一个逃避孤单的工具。
And so, like unknowingly, we start to use other people as ways to escape our feelings of loneliness.
你知道，性它就是一个很强烈的连接。
You know, sex, the sexual act itself is a very strong kind of connection.
很多孤单的人，他就觉得，哇，我其实追求是爱情，所以我只要有婚姻就可以解决我这个孤单的感觉。
So a lot of people think, oh, I'm just pursuing love. So if I get married, then I'll solve this feeling of loneliness.
可是到头来，他发现最难过的其实不是单身一个人。最难过的是他已经进入在一个婚姻状态里面，可是他还觉得孤单，因为他不知道怎么样去建立一个健康的关系。
But then they find out that once they enter into marriage, what the loneliness itself, it doesn't just go away. Actually, you feel really lonely within the marriage because you don't know how to develop a healthy relationship.
甚至有时候我们最难过的不是我一个人的时候感到孤单，而是我跟一群人在一起的时候，我感到很孤单。
Sometimes that sense of loneliness feels worse not when you're alone by yourself, but when you're with a bunch of other people and you feel really alone.
那既然我们追求的这一切明明是这样的美好。
And so if we seek after all these things and they look good.
这些美好的事情没有办法解我们心里面的渴，那这个解药到底是什么？
But they can't remedy that thirst inside of us. So what is the remedy?
这个解药到底是什么？
What's the remedy?
我想要 propose 孤单的解药，并不在乎你旁边有没有人，而是在你心里面有没有神。
But I want to propose that the cure to loneliness is not if there are people around you, but rather if you have God in your heart.
所以耶稣回答说：“要是你知道上帝的恩赐，又知道向你要水喝的是谁，你早就求他了，他也早就把活水给你了。”
That's why Jesus answered, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water."
耶稣对于小撒在这里有一个解答，他把小撒的注意力带到两件事情上面。
So here Jesus has an answer for Sammy. He points her to two things.
第一件事是上帝的恩赐。
The first is God's grace.
Okay, 上帝的恩赐。
God's grace.
你知道恩赐这个词，我们常常以为是只有属灵恩赐。
Sometimes when we talk about grace, maybe we'll think, oh, these are like spiritual gifts.
比如说使徒、先知讲道啊，说预言啊，好像它是一个能力。
So, for example, the apostle, prophets, you know, like it's kind of like those are the spiritual gifts.
可是在这里是在说赐下圣灵的这件事情。
But here Jesus is talking about the Holy Spirit.
也就是说，圣灵它本身就是上帝的恩赐。
And so God's grace is the Holy Spirit.
第二个是耶稣让他看到给活水的人是谁。
And the second part is Jesus let her see who it is that is giving her living water.
给活水的人是谁？
The one who's giving the living water.
因为耶稣就是这个活水的源头。
Because Jesus is the source of that living water.
小撒他们也有自己的国家的一个宗教信仰啊。
You know, Sammy, she also had her own culture and background.
她也可以试着向这些神明来求所谓的恩赐。
She could have gone to these gods and idols to ask for these gifts.
可是她怎么求都是一些替代品。
But whatever she asked for, it was all a substitute.
因为只有耶稣才是真正活水的源头。
Because only Jesus is the source of living water.
只有耶稣才真正知道我们需要的是什么。
Only Jesus really knows what we really need.
所以我们要问自己，我们有没有遇见这样的一个人，是能够给我们活水的人。
So we need to ask ourselves, have we met this person who can give us living water?
因为既然我们每个人被创造要连接，就代表这个需求在我们里面，我们本来就需要。
Because we've all been born with this innate desire for connection.
我们虽然想要对方来完全理解我们，完全这样爱我们，可是这样的需要只有神能够来满足。
So even though we hope and we want other people to understand us, actually that need inside of us is only be able to be met by God.
所以你看到有一些人不断不断走在这个错误的关系当中。
So you can see that some people are stuck in these relationships that aren't good for them.
可是他和我们没有不一样，他只是和我们一样需要这个真实的关系，亲密的连接啊。
But they're just like us. They also long for that intimate relationship and that connection.
这些人也很痛苦，他就觉得我控制不住啊，因为我需要被爱啊。
They think I can't control myself because I need to be loved as well.
所以这样真实亲密的关系，如果不是从神来的话，就很容易拿其他东西来取代。
So if that intimate connection isn't filled by God, it's really easy to take other things to become substitutes.
因为不管这些东西再怎么好，它都没有办法止渴。
So no matter how good those substitutes are, they cannot quench your thirst.
可能有一些人他会需要一些色情影片，有一些人需要酒精，或是各式各样的瘾头，可能需要打电动，或是各式各样的方式让自己麻痹，把自己那个孤单的感觉给掩盖起来。
Sometimes people use different addictions like pornography or alcohol or even video games just to numb that sense of loneliness.
我们如果口渴的话，还知道要找水喝。
You know, if we feel thirsty, we know we need to drink water.
可是当我们孤单的时候，当我们找错东西，这些东西只会让我们越来越渴。
But when we're lonely, but we take something that's not the right thing, it will actually make us thirstier.
我们明明是想要来逃避孤单，可是却让我们陷入更深的孤单。
You know, we want to run away from loneliness, but actually they lead us into deeper loneliness.
所以很多人他因为受伤，就把自己把别人来关在外面，可是他们也不小心把自己关在里面。
So some people, because they've been hurt by others, they shut people out. But what they're actually doing is also shutting themselves in.
啊，反正现在不用去外面吃饭嘛，那我叫 Uber Eats 就好啦。
You know, I can't go out to eat anyways, so I'll just order Uber.
我不用去办公室，我 work from home 就好了啦。
You know, and I don't need to go to the office, so I'll just work from home.
我不用再去小组聚会了，我只要在主日听信息，我看直播就可以了。
I don't need to go to a small group anymore, so I'll just watch the sermon online.
所以明明我们的需求就是被尊重、被爱、被关心。
So even though we desire, we need to be respected and loved and cared for.
可是孤单就会摧毁我们这样的关系。
But loneliness will break down those relationships.
所以我们失去了关系，这个人际关系，我们自然就会产生这种被隔离、被拒绝的感觉。
And when we lose those relationships, we'll start to feel isolated and alone.
所以不管你实际上有没有被伤害，这个越孤单的人对这个世界的信任感跟安全感会越来越低。
So whether or not you've gone through deep hurts before, actually, when you become lonely, that sense of loneliness will become deeper and deeper.
我们越离开人群，我们就越难对人信任，然后开始一个恶性的循环。
And the farther you move away from people, the less you're able to trust them, and it's just this vicious cycle.
我们想要避免摩擦，因为我们不想要跟其他人冲突啊。
You want to avoid conflict with people.
可是我们就在这个很安心很习惯的一个不舒服里面，我们也不想要去面对一个我们没有办法预知的伤害。
So we stay within this kind of safe but very uncomfortable situation.
所以有一些人在孤单当中，可是他们不知道自己很孤单。
So some people, they are in this loneliness, but they don't know that they're in it.
直到我们开始跟他们互动，看他们待人处事的时候才知道。
Until we start to interact with them, then we start to understand that they are lonely.
你可以感觉到，因为他们不懂得怎么爱人，也不懂得怎么样被爱。
You can sense it because they don't really know how to love people or accept people's love.
这样的生活其实很痛苦的。
Actually, to live like that, it's very painful.
可是其实每一个孤单的心背后都有一个想要被爱、被理解的需要。
But behind every lonely heart is actually this need to be loved and understood.
神在我们内心深处都放了这样的一个需求。
God placed this deep longing inside of our hearts.
我们都需要被爱、被理解。
We all need to be loved and to be understood.
因为被理解也是一种爱的语言啊，因为我们只要被理解的时候，就会感觉被连接。
Because feeling understood is also a love language. Because when we feel understood, we feel connected.
因为当对方如果没有真的了解你，就说他爱你的话，你会觉得那个爱很肤浅。
Because if someone doesn't understand you and they just say they love you, you still feel like that love is pretty superficial.
所以真正的爱是一定要建立在被理解上面。
So love needs to be built upon feeling understood.
这是为什么父母需要去和你的孩子来做朋友。
This is why, as parents, you still need to develop a friendship with your children.
而不是总是以上对下的来教训他们。
And not just remain in that top-down kind of relationship teaching them.
因为你要学会做朋友，你才会有真正的理解，你会有彼此的尊重，你才会有一个真正的勇于道歉、真实的爱。
Because as you develop that friendship, then that respect will be mutual and learning to say sorry and that love.
如果父母不知道怎么和孩子做朋友的话，你们的关系可能会只剩下一大堆规矩，或是经济上面的资源，甚至是只剩血缘关系。
You know, if you, as parents, you don't learn to develop a friendship with your children, maybe all you have left is a financial kind of relationship, or just your bloodline, or you just,
所以你知道很多在上位者他们感觉到很孤单因为他们不知道怎么和下面的人做朋友
So a lot of people in those superior positions or positions of leadership they feel lonely because they don't know how to become friends with people
甚至当我们职位越高的时候别人就越不敢来接近我们
And as our positions become higher people are more afraid to come close to us
可是你知道耶稣他是万王之王万主之主
But you know, Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
可是他不是高高在上的，要别人来服侍他。他是称门徒为朋友。
But he doesn't just sit up on his throne and want people to serve him. He called his disciples friends.
他要上十字架之前，还为所有的门徒来洗脚。
And before he went to the cross, he stooped down and washed his disciples' feet.
所以在这个故事里面，耶稣主动开启一个话题。
And so within this story, Jesus opens up this conversation.
他对小撒说，请你给我一点水吧。
And he asked Sammy, please give me a drink of water.
Wow, 你知道吗？犹太人跟撒玛利亚人他们是有宿仇的。
You know, at that time, there is this deep hatred between Samaritans and Jews.
他们是彼此老死不相往来的那一种。
They did not want contact with each other.
所以犹太人他们会用撒玛利亚人这个词来骂彼此，你知道吗？
So actually, Jewish people use the term Samaritan as a curse word.
举例来说，你可能在犹太的菜市场看到两个大妈在吵架。
So for example, you might go to the open market and you see these two aunties like bickering.
可以个大妈就很生气说，你干嘛插队啊？你是撒玛利亚人啊？
And maybe one of the aunties are like, why did you cut in line? Are you a Samaritan?
那个大妈就非常生气，就说，哈，你说我撒玛利亚人，你才撒玛利亚人，你全家都撒玛利亚人。
And the other auntie is like, huh? You call me a Samaritan? You're the Samaritan. Your whole family is Samaritan.
就代表你知道犹太人有多讨厌撒玛利亚人。
So see how it represents how much the Jews hated Samaritans.
所以当小撒看到耶稣来主动跟他要水喝的时候，他非常的惊讶。
So when Sammy saw that Jesus came to her for a drink of water, she was so astonished.
有多少人跟小撒一样？你觉得在神眼里面，你应该是要被他讨厌的。
How many of you are like Sammy? You think that in God's eyes, you should be despised by him.
你会觉得神，你这么圣洁，你一定讨厌像我这样的罪人啊。
You think, God, you're so holy, you must hate a sinner like me.
神，你这么完美，我这么多缺点，我哪有脸见你啊？
God, you're so perfect, I'm so imperfect. How can I even meet you face to face?
所以不管你是不是和这位妇人、这位小撒一样，你觉得自己被拒绝，你没有脸见人。
So maybe you're like Sammy, the Samaritan woman. You feel disgraced and you're unable to face people.
你不想遇到其他人，因为你觉得没有人真的了解你，也不会有人知道你的所作所为之后还能够继续爱你。
You think that no one wants to interact with you, and if they knew about you, they would not want to be with you.
你知道在圣经的这个经文的前一章，约翰福音的前一章。
You know, in the chapter previous to this.
有一个法利赛人叫做尼哥底母。
There was a Pharisee called Nicodemus.
他们法利赛人懂很多啊，知道很多的规条，也很会守规条啊。他们主动去找耶稣。
The Pharisees, they knew everything about the law, and they came to seek Jesus.
可是到了第四章，你看到小撒这个大罪人，却是耶稣主动来找他。
But here in the next chapter, this big sinner, this Samaritan woman, but Jesus came to her.
耶稣主动去找罪人。
Jesus initiated to go look after the sinner.
耶稣知道你的一切。
So Jesus knows everything about you.
他知道别人怎么看你。
He knows how others see you.
他也知道你怎么看你自己。
He knows how you see yourself.
可是他还是愿意主动来找你，他就是这样的谦卑。
But he still initiates this relationship with you. That's how humble he is.
所以耶稣说，人喝了这井里的水还会再渴，但是喝了我所赐的活水，永远不会再渴。我所赐的水要在他里面成为生命的泉源，永流不息，直到永生。
Jesus answered, Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life.
你知道永流不息这个永这个原文，它直接翻译就是跳出来。
You know, the welling up is kind of like the water jumps out.
它就是在很生动的比喻说，当圣灵在你里面的时候，你的那个喜乐，你的那个平安，你的那一切就是会这样涌流出来。它是有一个活泼的经历。
And so he's saying that when the Holy Spirit lives in you, you know, that joy and that peace, that life will be so vibrant, will just flow out of you.
它不只是一个生活的经历，而且它是神给我们的一个应许。
It's not just a life experience, but it's a promise that God gives to us.
接下来那个妇人他就撇下水罐回到城里对人们说你们快来看啊有一个人把我过去的事全都说了出来莫非他就是基督众人听了就到城外去看耶稣
Then leaving her water jar, the woman went back to the town and said to the people, Come, see a man who told me everything I ever did. Could this be the Messiah? They came out of the town and made their way toward him.
你知道，当一个人知道自己不配，可是得到神的恩典的时候，他很自然就会开始传福音，变成一位布道家。
You know, when someone knows that they're unworthy, but then they meet and encounter the grace of God, they naturally become evangelists.
所以当他在宣传说有一个人把我过去的事说出来的时候，可能别人会反问说，那你过去是什么事呢？
You know, maybe when she went to other people, be like, he told me everything I ever did. Maybe other people be like, well, what did you do?
在那时候，他就不得不说出自己的故事来成为见证。
And at that moment, she'll need to tell about her past and her story as a testimony.
所以原来你看犹太人跟撒玛利亚人他们不相往来，所以当时要旅行一定会绕路。
So at the time, because Jews and Samaritans didn't interact with each other, the Jewish people had to go around Samaria.
你知道耶稣当时他旅行的时候，明明有三条路可以走，可是大家都不会想要经过撒玛利亚这条路。
You know, at the time, Jesus could have chosen three other routes, and nobody normally would want to choose the route that went through Samaria.
可是这个故事有一个好消息，叫做耶稣必须经过撒玛利亚。
But there's good news in this story is that Jesus must go through Samaria.
因为耶稣说，我今天必须要来找你。
Because Jesus said, today I must go and find you.
因为神完完全全的了解你。
Because God understands you completely.
就是因为他知道我们的一切，我们的挣扎，我们的黑历史，一切我们不想让人家知道的地方。
And it's because he knows everything about us, everything that we did that we're ashamed of, we don't want other people to know about.
可是他还是要亲近你，他还是要来爱你。
But he still wants to draw close to you, and he still wants to love you.
所以这个完全了解的是什么？神他来显明我们的罪，可是他没有要羞辱我们。
So this complete understanding, what is it? It's knowing everything we ever did, but not shaming us for it.
所以他特别找门徒不在的时间，因为他不要让小撒感到羞耻。
And so he chose a time when his disciples weren't around so that she wouldn't feel ashamed.
而且当小撒在说我没有丈夫的时候，耶稣还说你说的非常好。
And so when Sammy also confessed, I don't have a husband, Jesus replied, that is true.
而且耶稣没有拐弯抹角，他直接就让小撒知道，他不但完全知道他的罪，没有嫌弃，没有任何嫌恶，而且还很谦卑的请他帮忙。
So Jesus didn't beat around the bush, but he let her know that he knew everything about her, but he still humbly asked her for help.
所以在一开始的时候，我说，即便全世界最了解你的人，他也不会完全了解你。
So this is what I was talking about in the beginning when I said, even if there are people in your life that they understand you so well, but they could not completely understand you.
所以我们自然在追求的那个完全的契合，完全的了解，那样子的真爱， 只有耶稣是能够给我们的。
And that complete and perfect understanding and love that we are always seeking for, only Jesus can provide that.
所以有时候内心很感到孤单的时候，我们常常心里面会冒出一些我们根本不想犯的罪啊。
So sometimes when we feel lonely, actually we'll start to do things and we fall into sin that we didn't want to before.
可是我们却没有办法靠自己来摆脱那个孤单的感觉。
But we're unable to escape from that feeling of loneliness.
因为它就像是一个空瓶子一样，我怎么样不让那个空气进去，它就还是会进来。
Because it's like this empty jar. No matter how hard you try, you can't get that air out of there.
所以，唯一让一个空瓶子不再有空气的方式，就是我们必须把水倒进来，让水来充满这个瓶子。
So the only way you can fill an empty jar and take away the air is to fill that with water.
我们唯一解决的方式就是让神来进来，而且是让神来完全的充满。
So our only solution is to allow God to come in and to let him fill us completely.
就是因为耶稣他知道小撒心里很渴，需要有一个亲密的关系，所以耶稣说。
So Jesus understood that Sammy was so thirsty inside and longed for an intimate relationship. So he told her,
我要在你的心里成为生命的泉源，有源源不绝的活水，直到永生。
So he said that he will give that living water to her that will become a spring of water welling up to eternal life.
上帝会给你一个恩赐，是因为你能够因着他的爱去真诚的爱人，去无所求，主动的关心别人，成为别人的朋友。
And so God will give you this gift of being able to love other people without condition, and then you'll become their friend.
也当我们在私底下和神去坦诚这些我们做错的事情，我们才能够真实的去面对，我们也才能够来健康的爱自己。
And as we face all of our failures in front of God and be honest with Him, actually, that's when we can start to know and understand ourselves.
所以今天当你听到这篇信息的时候，你可能会觉得。哇，好像真的在说我哎。
So as you're listening to this sermon and you think, wow, this is really talking about me.
可是你不要觉得耶稣来到你生命只是来造访而已。你好像遇到耶稣说，哇，耶稣你好准哦，你都说中了耶。
I hope that you don't go away from this thinking, wow, Jesus, you're so accurate. You know everything about me.
然后我就觉得，我现在只要跟耶稣来合照 ，#我遇到耶稣，然后就是一个我生命的里程碑。很多朋友按赞，我就很开心了。
And then it's just this one-time experience where you take a photo and you put #met Jesus and then it becomes this trophy in your life.
耶稣今天告诉你说，我不是要来造访你，我是要来拯救你，因为我才是唯一的解药。
Because Jesus says, I'm not here just to visit you, but I'm here to save you because I am the only solution.
因为神没有要计划我们过一个孤单的生活，他要我们过的是一个合一、丰盛、与人连结的生活。
Because Jesus didn't make us to live a lonely life, but he created us to be connected with people, to have an abundant life.
可是你会问啦，可是圣经不是讲说神必与我们同在，必不撇下我们。也不丢弃我们吗？
But maybe you'll ask, but God says in the Bible that He will be with us and He will never forsake us.
那为什么我里面还有这样的一个空缺呢？
Then why do I still feel empty inside?
没错，神的应许还是存在。
Yes, God's promise is there.
可是神在他里面，他完全没有改变，变的是我们。
But he's not the one who has changed, but we are the ones who have changed.
因为当我们犯罪的时候，我们里面就感觉不到和神的合一、和神的契合、和神的同在。
Because when we fall into sin, we're unable to feel that connection with God.
所以有些人会因为犯罪之后觉得神没有原谅他，会定他的罪，所以就没有办法和神持续享有这样子亲密的关系。
So when we fall into sin, sometimes we feel like we're unable to meet with God and unable to have that relationship with Him again.
就好像我们跟一个人吵架的时候，即便两个人什么都没说，可是空气当中你就是感觉到那个拒绝、那个冷漠、那个不舒服在你们彼此当中。
It's like after you have an argument with someone, even if you're not talking anymore, you can still sense that sense of rejection and the coldness there.
可是这并不是神命定要给我们的关系。
But this isn't the kind of relationship God has promised for us.
所以我们才需要和神来和好，和神恢复关系。
That's why we need to reconnect and have a restore a relationship with God.
所以只要你愿意相信耶稣，他会为我们付上代价，今天就没有任何一件事情可以阻隔你和耶稣的关系。
So if you believe that Jesus has paid the price, then nothing can separate you from His relationship with you.
因为我们唯有和神愿意恢复这样的关系，有这样的连结， 我们才能够合神的心意来爱人爱自己和人连接
So it's only when we are restored in our relationship with Jesus that we're able to connect again with God and with other people.
你知道我在青少女的时候其实很害怕孤单
You know, when I was a teenager, I was so afraid of being alone.
我常常一个人，可是我就总是放着音乐。
So I would, when I was alone, I would spend a lot of time listening to music.
因为很多好听的音乐可以陪伴我，我会听古典，我会听摇滚，我会听各式各样不同的音乐。
So I would have some classical music or rock and roll, and this music would accompany me.
我会把很多时间来专心的欣赏音乐，因为我觉得音乐是我最好的朋友，让我不会孤单。
So I would put a lot of spend a lot of time listening to music because I would think music is my best friend and I don't have to be lonely.
到一个地步，我连睡觉的时候都要听音乐。
To the extent that I had to listen to music even when I was sleeping.
可是到后来我才发现
，But afterwards I discovered
我需要音乐的原因是因为我不想面对自己一个人。
The reason why I needed music so much was because I didn't want to face being alone.
因为当周遭一安静下来的时候，我就会发现自己是一个人。
Because as my surroundings quieted down, I realized that I'm all by myself.
可是我没有办法面对自己。
But I wasn't able to face myself.
因为我根本不喜欢自己。
Because I didn't like myself.
我常常这样宅在家里，因为我知道我出去会被别人拒绝。
So I would stay at home because I knew that if I go out, I'd be rejected by other people.
可是当我有机会出去接触到别人的时候，我又会想要得到别人的肯定，别人的赞美。
But when I did go out and interact with people, I would always try to seek their approval and their praise.
因为只有这样，我才会觉得不孤单。
Then I would feel that I'm not lonely.
可是不管我用什么样的方法来填补我里面的空缺，我都没有一个真正的满足。
But no matter how hard I tried to fill that emptiness inside, I was never satisfied.
可是直到我认识神，真的和神相交的时候，我开始花时间和神独处。
But when I came to know God and I started to spend time alone with Him,
当我开始学着用神眼光来看自己的时候，我才开始享受这个一个人的时间。
And I started to learn to use his perspective to see myself. Then I started to enjoy being alone.
你知道有一次我和一群朋友出去，我们非常的开心，大家有一个 quality time， 吃饭聊天，聚会非常的热闹。
One time I went out with a group of friends and we're having so much fun. You know, we're eating together and we're laughing.
我也很享受和朋友在一起。
And I really enjoyed being with them.
可是当我回家的时候，那时候一打开门，只有一个人。
But when I came back home and I opened the door and I was all by myself,
当一切都沉淀下来，一切安静下来，我感觉是我一个人的时候，我超级兴奋，我就跟神说：“神，终于只剩我们两个了。”
And then when everything settled down, and then I realized I'm just by myself, I was so excited. And I said, "God, finally, I get to spend time alone with you."
我可以享受和人在一起，我可以享受和神在一起，我可以享受。我自己一个人的时间，这三个需要一个健康的平衡。
I can enjoy being with my friends. I can enjoy being with God and with myself. You know, these three need to be in balance.
因为当我们如果更多的来活出神创造的自己，我们就更有能力来健康的爱人建立关系。我们对孤单的焦虑感就会更低。
So as we start to live out who God created us to be, we can start to have healthy relationships, and the anxiety about being lonely will drop.
你知道神有一个名字叫做以马内利。
One of God's names is Emmanuel.
以马内利意思是上帝与我们同在。
It means God is with us.
上帝与我们同在。
God with us.
因为当神创造了我们以后，我们里面是有一个位置是只有神可以填满的。
Because when God created us, there is a space inside that only God can fill.
如果这个位置不是由神来填满的话，我们就永远不会有真正的喜乐跟满足。
And if that space isn't filled by God, we could never have true joy and satisfaction.
所以圣灵来到这个世上的一个目的，就是因为我们里面都有这个饥渴。
So the Holy Spirit came because each and every one of us has this thirst inside.
这个饥渴就是我们和神需要有一个连接真实的关系。
And this thirst is the longing for this connection with God.
可是圣灵要帮助我们这个饥渴在今世就能够得到满足，直到永生。
And the Holy Spirit came so that we can be satisfied from now until eternity.
所以耶稣基督他为我们死在十字架上，就是为了要让我们和神的关系可以和好。
So Jesus came and died on the cross so that we can have a restored relationship with God.
所以不管你做过什么事，不管你现在几岁，你知道，你只要愿意，神都能够来救你。
So no matter how old you are or what you've done, as long as you're willing, God can save you.
如果今天你听到这篇信息，你听到我在说一颗孤单的心，你感觉那就是你的内心的话，我想要等一下来为你祷告。
If you've been listening to this sermon and you heard about this lonely heart and you feel that is me, I want to take some time to pray for you.
因为有一些人，你的孤单感在你里面已经太久了，你觉得已经没有救了，你试过各种方式了，你都没有办法走出来。
Because for some of you, you lived with a sense of loneliness for so long and you've just simply given up. You think nothing can save you.
可是耶稣今天说，我今天不是要来遇见你，我今天是要来拯救你。
But Jesus says, I'm not here just to give you a visit, but I'm here to save you.
如果我说的是你的话，不管你人在哪里，我想邀请你把你的手放在心上，我要来为你做祷告。
So if what I'm saying is talking about you, I just invite you to place your hand on your heart, and I want to pray for you right now.
请你把手放在心上，让我来为你做这个祷告。
Place your hand on your heart, and I want to pray for you.
亲爱的父神
，Dear Father,
谢谢你从来没有离弃我。
Thank you for never abandoning me.
谢谢你，当我不爱自己的时候，你还是深深爱着我。
Even when I didn't know how to love myself, you still loved me deeply.
谢谢你，总是在我远离你的时候，你还是耐心的等待我。
Thank you for being so patient even when I'm far from you.
我谢谢你，总是用你的爱来挽回我，让我不致羞愧。
Thank you for always winning me back with your love and taking away my shame.
我求你来赦免我一切的过犯。
Father, I pray that you will forgive me of all my sins.
让我更多来渴慕你跟跟随你。
So that I would desire you more and follow you.
享受和你的亲密关系。
And enjoy a close relationship with you.
到一个地步是我可以用你的爱来爱我周遭的人。
So close that I'm able to love other people with the love you've given to me.
让这些人可以来看见你的荣耀。
So that the people around me can see your glory.
我们祷告是奉主耶稣宝贵的名求。
We pray this in Jesus' precious name.
Amen, amen,
amen.
我今天想做一个特别的邀请。
I want to give an extended special invitation.
如果在我们当中，你还没有把你的生命交给耶稣基督的话
，If you haven't given your life to Jesus yet,
今天有一个机会，我想要带你做祷告。
There's an opportunity now, and I want to lead you in a prayer.
因为耶稣他上十字架是要担当我们所有的罪。
Because Jesus went on the cross to bear all of our sins.
他代替我们接受刑罚，好让我们和父神可以恢复关系。
He received the penalty we should have deserved, and then in order to restore the relationship with the Father.
所以如果今天你说，主，我想要来跟随你。
And so if you say today, Lord, I want to follow you.
我想要认识你，我想要有你的样式。
I want to know you, I want to be like you.
如果这是你的话，你第一次把你的生命交给耶稣基督。
If this is you, you're giving your life to Jesus for the very first time.
我想邀请你，不管你人在哪里，你也可以来把手举起来，我带你做一个祷告。
I want to invite you wherever you are to lift up your hands and I want to pray for you.
现在我会说一句，我邀请你也说一句。
And as I say a phrase, I invite you to repeat after me.
我们的翻译 Joy 他会说英文，你可以用你习惯的语言来祷告。
And you can use the language you're comfortable with.
亲爱的天父
，Dear Heavenly Father,
我们来到你的面前。
We come before you.
谢谢你让你的独生爱子耶稣基督。
Thank you for sending your beloved Son.
为我们死在十字架上
，to die for us on the cross，
并且在第三天复活
，and he raised to life on the third day，
让我们能够拥有一个全新的生命
，so that we are able to have a brand new life。
我承认我是一个罪人
I confess that I am a sinner.
求你来赦免我所有的过犯。
Please forgive me of all my sins.
并且带领我来跟随你。
And lead me to follow you.
奉耶稣基督宝贵的名祷告。
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
谢谢你收看我们的 Hope 的频道，希望今天的讲道有祝福到你。你也先别急着离开，可以订阅我们的频道，你就不会错过所有精彩讲道跟影片。如果你喜欢这个影片，也可以分享给你的朋友，你也可以点选下面的铃铛，这样子我们每一次有新的影片出来的时候，你都可以收得到。当然，如果你想要继续的支持我们的事跟我们的教会，请你可以用奉献的方式，可以点选 Give Now 来继续支持我们建立这个教会、这个家。谢谢你今天的收看，我们下次再见。